Welcome back to my channel, and if you're new, hey, what's up? My name is Tanya, and thank you all so much for joining in and watching this video. This video is going to be an eye tutorial on how to achieve this eye look. I had a request to do an eye tutorial based on a mint green eye look, and I had to dig hard to find a mint green eyeshadow. I really thought it was going to be so simple to find mint green. Like, as soon as I received that request, I was thinking of all these different palettes, like right down to one of the Natasha Denona palettes. I was envisioning all of these like mint green colors, and nope, none of them were mint green. But I did happen to have one single eyeshadow from Makeup Geek that happened to be a foiled shadow that was mint green. So Makeup Geek came through, and I had just bought a bunch of Makeup Geek last Black Friday when they had a huge sale, and then I showed you guys my Z palette in one of my videos. Maybe it was I don't remember, but you saw all of those, and like I thought of that shade, but I thought that I had like so many options. I spent almost an hour swatching greens on my hand trying to find a mint green. Everything's like deep green, emerald green, aquamarine green. Like it's crazy. Like palettes don't have, or they're like matte green. Like neon greens, like light flush color greens, pastel greens. Like I had greens coming out of everywhere except mint. It was unbelievable. So, but then this baby worked. So I really hope that you guys like this eye look that I came up with, especially the person who requested it, because I thought that lavender would look really pretty with mint green. So I'm very happy with how it did turn out. I just cannot believe that palettes don't have mint green, because it is such a pretty color. Like with it on the lid, it pops so much. I like really love this color. And you guys know I have a ridiculous eyeshadow palette collection. And to me, like swatching them, there were so many swatches where I was like, no, that has like too much of an aqua color in it. And no, that has too much emerald in it. And I don't know, that's just me being like super picky about color, because I'm like, no, there's like a hint of this, there's a hint of that. But I was like determined to try to find what I thought is mint green. But let me know, whoever requested the mint green, if this is not the color, the shade that you did have in mind. Maybe we have different ideas of mint green. Maybe you are thinking of a deeper green. Just let me know, and I can also always do another look. So this is what I came up with, because based on your wording, this is my take on a soft mint green, you know, doing a soft lilac. That's why I kept like the wing subtle and subdued. Highlight, I went ham like I always do, but I mean, you don't have to do the highlight. It was about the eye look. So just let me know if there was a different shade that you wanted me to use, and if this is not, like I said, we didn't have the same idea of the mint green. So anyway, if you guys want to see how to get this eye look, then just keep on watching. So I have a request to do a soft mint green eye look. And when I got the request, I was thinking of like this palette. I was like, oh, it's so awesome. I even thought like my Natasha Denona green brown palette. And then I was thinking like all these different palettes off the top of my head that had like soft mint green eyeshadows in them, that I thought had soft mint green eyeshadows in them. I was mistaken. I literally just spent the last 50 minutes swatching green, what looked like the closest thing to green mint eyeshadow colors, like in every palette that had greens imaginable, my Z palettes, everything. I pulled as much as I could. Apparently, mint green is not that common in palettes. I found like so many ranges of greens, from like rich deep greens to emerald greens to like mermaid greens, aquamarine greens, then like these like greens that are like green blues but not minty greens. It was like, I don't know, every kind of green imaginable but a mint green. I think I found something like some that are close enough to a mint green, so I'm just gonna pull out a look with what I can. I pulled out a couple I pulled out quite a few different palettes and a pigment, so we're just gonna go from there and see what happens. I have an idea of what to do. I know you said a soft mint green. I don't know if you mean like a soft eye look or the shade itself you wanted soft. I just realized that now that I'm sitting here. So I won't do like a double cut crease or anything crazy like that. I'll leave it more like blown out and soft that way, and minty green, because I just realized I'm not sure if the soft was like to keep it a soft eye look or soft in color. Shoot. Well, I can always do another look. So if you're not happy with this look, let me know and I'll do another one. So I'll just pull something out. I just won't do anything like harsh and crazy and like the double wing cut crease, like that type of design. I'll keep it more on the, you know, building the crease and building different green shades, and then having a couple stars of the show on the lid. I didn't grab glitters, so I guess we'll just see what happens and go from there. So I'm gonna zoom you guys in now, and I'm not really sure what to do, because like I said, I don't have like a perfect shade. I just have a couple shades that are fairly close to a green mint, so we'll see what happens. So I'm gonna start my transition shades with the Lorac I Heart Brunch Pro Palette. And we're gonna start with, I think, Pancakes for the first transition shade using my Karity E31 brush. Now I'm gonna dip into Mimosa, this shade. Same thing. Now I'm going to grab Avocado Toast and do the same thing. Since I am not sure if she wanted just like a soft look, I am going to leave it just like this for transition shades for now. I might build a little bit more, but I think I'm going to leave it like this. And I'm going to take my Makeup Geek pigment in Fantasy Foiled Eyeshadow and put that down as a base for my eyelid. So I'm going to grab, where did my MAC 242 go? I will be right back. Apparently, after I cleaned all my brushes, that was the only one I put back in its home instead of laying it out with the other ones. So I'm going to coat that on the MAC 242. And then Milani Her Up. See, this one was like jumping out in my mind too when I got that mint green request. I was like, oh, I have a Makeup Geek pigment or foiled eyeshadow that's going to be perfect. But oh, that is. See, when I finger swatched it, this did not seem that minty green. This is coming off way more mint green now. Okay, good. Because this is what I thought the color was. And then I swatched it. I was like, damn it! But finger swatches compared to a brush with some spray, it makes a huge difference. Now I have this Naked Cosmetics MN04 Mother Nature. It's this kind of green. And I'm gonna try and put this a little bit of this on the inner corner. It comes in like this powder. I'm gonna just dip my Morphe or my MAC 242 right in there. This one would be great to spray some or mix it with Dirline, but when I was at IMATS last year, they literally just used water and it transformed it. So I'm just gonna Milani it, because why waste Dirline when Milani really transformed it? But I don't know if this is gonna add. There we go. Too much, because Makeup Geek is just on another level. So now that I did get it nice and minty, I'm going to go back into the Lorac I Heart Brunch palette and take Lavender on my Karity E31. And now this is going to be a little trickier, but I do want to bring some other colors other than just green in here and put a little purple. But I might need to grab something more pigmented. I'm going to take Makeup Geek's Chit Chat and just do one coat. This looks like it's really dark, but I do need to get coverage over all of this, because I do want just like a lilac, lavender type of tone. Alright, I want to clean up under my brow, because during that process of trying to make it purple rather than green, I had to go like way up there and work the crap out of it. So I'm going to take my Viseart editorial palette, because it's got a nice white in there, and my Morphe M507, and just try to clean that up a little bit for later on before we highlight. You could use concealer too to clean up under here. This is just like easier and quicker. All right, I'm gonna go line, do my face, and then I will be back to do the lower lash line. So I finished up my face and there were some disappointments in that. So I tested out the Hourglass Vanish foundation sticks, which I know have been around forever, but I just hauled them in my Sephora haul, and I'm not that impressed. I really don't get the hype. I did do a mini video, so I won't go into like too much detail on these. I get the hype in the sense that they're very buildable. You can sheer them out. I obviously went for full coverage, and I want them for full coverage, but using them for full coverage feels very heavy and cakey. Like, my face feels like I put on like 10 pounds of makeup right now, and it's really uncomfortable. And it just isn't like a beautiful finish. Like, it's nice, But for the price point and how little product you get, and one of my sticks, the tip came broken off inside of here. And I didn't open these like during the unboxing, like to look at them. So I didn't even realize that it was broken. So I'm like, really? It already comes with so few products, and then my tip was broken. But I think I'm gonna be returning these anyway, because if you are somebody who does, you know, a light, natural type of foundation, maybe even medium, you probably will like these. But if you go for it full coverage, you really feel it. And I have those other full coverage foundations I've reviewed and told you guys about that you like just don't feel. And why wear a full coverage stick that you can feel? So I'm not a huge fan of those. And then, but the finish was like full coverage and, you know, like got what I was trying to achieve. I just didn't like feeling it. And then I tested out the Giorgio Armani Microfill Loose Powder in Universal Nude. And I was expecting this to blow my mind. One, it's Armani. And two, I've used the Armani Compact that is like a foundation, but when you know, get the light shade, it just acts as a setting powder. And it's so good. And this was so bad. It broke the foundation apart. Like, I'm having serious issues because my forehead is so broken apart after I set it. And then I tried to go over it with some more foundation, just hoping for a Hail Mary that it would work. And it didn't. It just chunked up more, which I expected it to because it was trying to go over powder. So I took a makeup removing wipe, trying to like just remove what happened on my forehead and then reapply. And then that got patchy all over again. And then it broke apart on my cheeks on two spots. It broke apart all down my nose. Like, this was terrible. So as soon as my battle video goes up, this is going back to Sephora. But now we've got good things to talk about. So I used another one of the NYX Ombre blushes that I called in Mauve Me. So I don't think you can really see it, but that's the blush I'm using. And do not be fooled. This is so pigmented. When I did that finger swatch, it barely showed up. So I was like, okay. And I was like, oh. But it blended out like nothing. These are such incredible blushes. It is unbelievable. They are so, so pigmented. Like, you barely need anything. Or you can go like and build and build and build until the level of intensity that you want. Like, it is wonderful. So this is such a freaking win. I'm in love with these blushes. This was an amazing new release. Then the crazy glow that I've got going on is Anastasia's Glow Kit in Sweets. I used Sassy Grape. I haven't used this one in a very long time, so that's the lavender. And then I put, I don't know if you guys can really see, but on the very high points, mirror image, I actually went into the Beach Cosmetics Blacklight Highlight 6 color palette, and I grabbed the green shade Laser and just put a little bit of Laser there, and then I took Strobe and put Strobe under my brow bone. So that is the glow going on. Then I tested out the Tom Ford bronzer. Oh my god, and this is gorgeous. It is such a beautiful top shade. I mean, without Rhodes, those are my initials. These are actually my legal initials because I haven't done a name change yet. So those are even my initials. But this bronzer is beautiful. It is so blendable. Just ignore the forehead, because the forehead is a disaster for me trying to fix the mess up that this caused. But this was so buildable and so blendable too. I'm keeping this baby. This baby is not going anywhere. This is staying with me. Like, it just, it's not going anywhere. And then I have my Colored Rain Faux Mink Lashes in Checkmate on. Then I also have Dina's Gift on my lips. I put the Burberry of, what was it, Liquid Lip Velvet Fawn number 5 on my lips, and I love this. You can't even tell that it's a liquid lip. It is actually creamy, not drying. I'm shocked. This is like such a great liquid lip formulation. Like, it is beautiful, and it's like such a nice warm tone nude. Like, it's not like a washed out nude. It's not like a dark brown. I'm like, I love this. I've never tried a Burberry liquid lip. Well, I guess it's liquid lip velvet. It says it's a bold and matte whipped lip cream. So there's like a whole lot of things going on in this formula, and it's a whole lot of goodness going on in this formula. This is awesome. And I did my tight line and water lining using my Ardency and Monster in black. I did my wing with my Tom Ford eye defining pen. And I think that is everything. There's just like so much stuff scattered because I tried to clean up as best as I could after that Sephora haul. And there's still things everywhere right now. We're just gonna put that over there. All right, yes, we're caught up. So I'm gonna zoom you guys in now, and we're gonna get going on finishing up this lower lash line. So, oh, I just realized, I don't wanna give you guys false information. I never do, obviously, but I did have my Bite Beauty lip mask on while I was doing my face and everything else, and then there was like the littlest bit left over before I did put that Burberry liquid lip on. So I will keep you updated if it is just as creamy and amazing of a liquid lip without the Bite Beauty lip mask underneath, because that could be actually adding to the creaminess of the formulation. The description of the formulation does sound like it is going to be as in like just as moisturizing as it is right now and not as drying as a normal liquid lip, but I did just realize that, so I didn't want to tell you guys that just in case you are somebody who doesn't like liquid lipsticks and then I tell you that this one's like the creamiest and the most non-drying liquid lipstick in the whole wide world, and then you go get it and it's expensive and then it turns out that it is still a little bit drying like most liquid lipsticks. I don't know for sure yet, so I have to keep you guys posted on that, so don't hold me to it yet. Alright, so starting with under the lash line, I'm going to take my new, I haven't used this baby yet, Marc Jacobs Highliner Gel Crayon in Whirlpool. Look at her, she's all fresh and new and ready to be smudged away. That's some pigmentation. There is seriously just no other formulation like these. Like, I know they're pricey, but they are pricey for a reason, not just because of Marc Jacobs' name. Like, this is just, I have never used such a creamy eyeliner in my life, and I have tried so many eyeliners. These are just so creamy, they glide on so effortlessly. They're gonna cause like so much less wrinkle damage to the delicate eye area. It's just so good. All right, now I'm gonna grab my Sephora Pro Smudge Brush, and taking that same purple that we used earlier, I'm going to don't want to smudge it or smoke it. I guess let's, okay, I want to smoke it first. Okay, that's the clean one. I'm going to take a Morphe M506 and there we go. to the lower lash line. Does not want to smoke over the liner. Now I'm going to smudge the purple. Now I'm going to dip back into the main foiled green shade that we have from Makeup Geek on the smudge brush. And Dumbo's complaining because he wants, I'm going to say supper because they know the D word. I'm going to spray her with some Milani and we're going to put a little bit right in the center. Now going into the Blacklight palette, we're going to take a Morphe M507 and dip into Strobe and highlight the inner corner. Okay, this makeup look is complete. I'm just going to go get dressed, do my hair, and I will be right back. Thanks so much for watching this video. I really hope that you guys like this eye look as much as I do. This is so something that I would never have created had it not been for that request. So I really do love you guys requesting videos because it keeps me on my toes, it keeps me challenged, it keeps me having to be creative and keeps me having to come up with new color schemes, new ideas. I mean, the prep time is not always fun when, for some reason, companies don't feel like including certain shades and palettes, but that is completely okay. It comes with the territory, and I love the challenge of hunting it down and making it happen, because there's no way in my insane collection that I can't freaking find something and make it work. So I keep writing down the requests as they are coming, so do not worry, nothing is getting overlooked. It's just that, you know, a lot of requests keep coming in, so they're getting checked off as, you know, as I can get them done, so they will all be getting fulfilled, I hope. I mean, if all of a sudden I have like 200 requests, that will take 200 days. But I'm not at that point yet, so we're still good. But I will be always doing your requests for makeup looks before what I want to do for makeup looks. Because, like, I'm dying to play with all of my Sephora makeup right now, for instance, but I am not going to touch my Sephora makeup until I catch up on everybody's makeup request looks first. So that's my plan. So that is what I'm going to do. So if you guys still have requests, keep them coming. I'm going to jot them down. And then, I mean, if you have a request where you want to know, actually somebody did have a request about, or a question about one of the hot products that I hauled. It was something to do with Estee Edit. I have to go back and read it because it came in right before I was filming and I didn't have a chance to go through comments right before I was filming. So if there's questions like that in relation to products that I purchased, then I will use that product and put it to the test so I can answer the questions, because otherwise I can't answer questions either and be helpful in that sense. So I do have to make a balance, but either way, you guys come before me in what I want to do for my makeup looks. So I'm here to help you guys out in what you guys want for tutorials and help you be able to have something to recreate. So that's my point anyway. So feel free to leave requests. Feel free to leave your comments, your questions, your feedback, your everything. I love it. I love our interaction. I love everything. So until that is it for this video. And until next time, good night, good morning, wherever you are. I love you guys so much, and I will talk to you later. Bye.